Now, this is one of my favourite parts of the week, actually, because this is when we get to talk about the BBC's DNA Family Secrets. Of course, it features Leicester's genetics expert, Professor Turi King, who, in essence, tries to answer questions from people all over the UK that, in many ways, really, truly changes their lives. Well, Clare was on the show last night. I'm thrilled to say that she and Turi join us now. Hey, guys, how are you both?
Hi.
Hi.
Fine.
Clare, tell us a little bit about your story from last night.
So my story was based on the fact that I did not know the identity of my biological father. And it's obviously something that's always been in my head. And my mum passed away 10 years ago now. So there's no more question that I can do with her about this. So going down the DNA route was the only way I had any idea of, you know, finding out who I was or what I'm made of or my heritage or anything.
What had caused the question in the first place? Because I know that this is something that's really incredibly important. One of those questions that's always at the back of your mind.
Yes. So my mum always told me who my biological father was, a British soldier, and she was adamant it was him, and the story never changed. And then after she passed away, a family friend approached me to say that she believed somebody else was actually my biological father. And the man in question had also passed away. So again, there was no way of me finding out. And it just made everything more difficult because I couldn't have this conversation with my mum. I then started to believe maybe it was the other person, that my mum had lied to me all these years. And it was just an awful feeling. It was a really, really hard feeling to have that doubt for so long. So I took up the opportunity to go with DNA.
What was it, the person that sort of sowed that seed of doubt in your mind, what had caused that person to think that your mum may have been lying to you?
Well, I grew up in North Belfast and I was very much an odd person out. I was so dark and black hair and looked different to everybody else, apart from this one family. And it was one of the girls in the family that had came and told me that she believed that her father was my father. And they had always believed this, but never raised it with me until that time. But apparently a lot of people thought that because we all looked alike, and it was a rumor that started and spiraled. And I started to believe it myself.
True. You know, when you get involved, and this is absolutely the case with Clare, is there is no other place to go to get answers to these really massive questions.
No, and I think that's something that really comes across with Clare's story, is that all of these avenues had sort of closed. So the only way that we could answer this was by using DNA. And so it's that opportunity for her to get answers to some pretty big questions about her life and kind of who she is, I suppose. It's a big thing for Clare to be going through. This is why I'm always in awe of our contributors, because they're allowing us to kind of go on this very emotional journey that's very personal.
Yeah, and you're always very clear to make no promises, because in some senses you're in the lap of the gods, aren't you? Dependent on whether you can find DNA matches, whether that person's on a database somewhere. It's a really complex thing.
So it's interesting because with Clare's case, a question was about what her ancestry was. And that's something that we knew we could answer pretty darn quickly because that's very straightforward to do. We were really lucky with Clare because she had a name as to who her mom had said was her biological father. And that actually made it quite quick for us because we could look for that surname in any DNA matches that Clare had. Was there anyone in the matches that had that surname in there that would allow us to kind of home in on, is this the family? Mm-hmm. And there were. So with a lot of this stuff, you're really at the mercy as to who's on the databases. So we're lucky with that. But in terms of showing whether or not this was her dad, that was actually relatively straightforward to do.
Claire, what's it like? I haven't asked this of any of the contributors so far. What's it like at that moment where you sit down in front of Turi in that room and she says, hey, what do you want to know? What's that like?
Oh my gosh, it is. I was so nervous. I have never been more nervous in my life. And I met Turi just before I went in and she gave me the biggest hug and made me feel so comfortable. So when I finally sat in that chair, I was calm, getting the results, very, very nervous, sitting, looking at her and trying to read her. You can't, you know, she wasn't giving anything away.
She'd make a great poker player.
She really would.
You know, and it seems to me, Clare, that one of the lovely things, in front of, I was talking to my wife about this, is that both Turi and Stacey are just the warmest people. I don't know Stacey, I do know Turi, and I know Turi to be one of the nicest people I know. And it's more like a sort of a televisual hug, isn't it?
Oh my goodness. I could not have gone through this whole journey if Stacey and Turi had not been involved, because they made it so much easier for me. The whole production team are fantastic, but Turi is just the kindest, loveliest person ever, and just made me feel so comfortable with the whole situation, regardless of what the result was going to be. I knew I was going to be okay.
Well, we've made Turi blush, which is hilarious. But Clare, tell us then what the DNA found.
So the DNA results showed that my mum had been telling me the truth the whole time, and it was a British soldier. And not only was Turi and the team able to tell me that, but they were able to identify him, contact him, and I was given photographs and a letter from him, which I was not expecting any of that. I was expecting to find out my DNA as to where I'm from in the world, but I did not expect the outcome that I got. It's been amazing.
Are you in contact? Are you in touch? Is that happening?
Yes, he's so lovely. He's such a nice man. He lives in England, and we would speak to each other maybe once every 2 weeks, and he would text every other day. And so a lot of contact. We haven't met yet. We've not actually even discussed that yet because it is all very new, but I'm hoping that's going to be the next step, that I can pop over to England and see him at some point.
I kind of blithely say it's life-changing, but it truly is, isn't it? Because there's sort of before DNA Family Secrets and after.
Oh, completely. It gives you your identity. It's completely life-changing, not just for me, but for my family, for my children. They now, when the stage comes in life that they're doing their family tree, you know, they're going to be able to know their whole ancestry. You know, they're going to be able to put everything together with ease because of what we've done on the show.
Look, and apart from anything else, apart from your heredity and so on, it also puts to bed the question about whether your mum lied to you or not. She didn't.
That has been the most important thing, because I had this doubt for so many years, and again, not being able to talk to her about this. Then I started to have these feelings, but I was quite angry with her. And then I couldn't prove, you know, why am I being angry? I don't know if, you know, this is the truth or what the truth is. So she was telling me the truth the whole time. Everything just feels more at peace with that now as well, because, you know, she's not here. And that just completed everything for me.
Clare, it's lovely to have you on the show. It really is. Turi, again, always lovely. Good luck for the future, Clare.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.